You know, over my life, I like to equate things with examples. And I always use examples of training, because training has been a big part of my life. Not as important as religion or family or anything like that, but it's played a significant part in my life as a teenager right through to a middle-aged man. Okay? And the hardest workout to do, everyone will tell you, is legs. Legs is the hardest. Where everyone wants to skip leg day, okay? But it's also the most beneficial. It's also the most effort to reward ratio high. So the hour that you spend in the gym doing legs, you're never going to get a bench workout or an arm workout that's ever going to evaluate to the same quality of workout, okay? So Ramadan is the leg workout, okay? People have a mindset of Ramadan that they're just waiting to get through the day so they can eat and drink and fill themselves up, okay? You're never going to get a better effort to reward ratio in your life than Ramadan. I don't look forward to I do look forward to iftar. Of course I do. Of course I want to eat and drink. It's natural. You haven't been eating and drinking since the early hours, you know, since Fajr, before Fajr. But the reality is I really like the fasting. You know, I really like that effort that you have to put in, the headaches, you know, the sort of sometimes slightly nauseous, tired, fatigue. I like this. I like this because, you know why? Because Allah loves this. And I do this, hopefully, fisibilillah, for the sake of God. And you're never going to get a better trade-off in effort to reward ratio than that. So for me, I like the fasting side of it. And the eating, I eat very little, you know, comparatively to what I would normally eat the rest of the year. So, alhamdulillah. Enjoy your fasting, people. It's not all about the eating and the drinking. It's about that little bit of sacrifice for that huge amount of reward that you get at the end of it, inshallah. Yeah. Peace.